Chris Markowski is joining me today. He is the host of Watchdog on Wall Street, as well as the founder of Markowski Investments. Chris, thanks so much for joining me today.
My pleasure. Thank you.
So as usual, we are talking about the jobs report from November. It's being reported that 245,000 jobs were added. The unemployment rate dropped from 6.9% to 6.7%. Can you break down these numbers for us? Are they better or worse than what we were expecting?
I expected that we were going to be hitting a wall at some point in time. There's only so much you can do when you have so many states and sectors of the economy that, for all intents and purposes, are either operating at 10 or 25% capacity. You can only go so far. And you're also talking about usually during the Christmas season, many department stores and malls bringing in all sorts of workers. And we obviously didn't see that happen this year. So the numbers, it wouldn't surprise me, let me put it this, wouldn't surprise me next month that we actually go negative. That's how dire the situation I see it right now. I think that the numbers, considering all we're going through, are not that bad. But again, don't expect much going forward unless, of course, again, we start opening up, the vaccine starts getting out to the degree that we need it to be. I mean, there's only so far we can go. You take a look at the labor participation numbers, on the weak side, not to mention schools being shut down, moms having to stay home with their kids. That's going to be very difficult on them as well. There's also a really interesting number talking about baby boomers are having a difficult time getting back in. One of the good parts the first 3 years of Donald Trump's presidency is because we limited it to the amount of H-1B and H-2B visa holders that come here into the country. We were bringing actually baby boomers back into the workforce. They're having a difficult time getting back in.
And I know this week there were talks about another stimulus package. Interestingly enough, though, this package wouldn't necessarily include, from my understanding, that stimulus check that we saw with the first stimulus package, but it would include enhanced unemployment insurance and state funding. So minus the check, what do you think of this package that's being proposed?
Well, there's also a little bit more in there as well, even though it's not as comprehensive as I'd like it to be in regards to protection for businesses from lawsuits. I think that that's great. We do need to extend unemployment. Obviously not at the ridiculous level that they had prior. That was just ridiculous at $600 additional on top of everything else. It made actually hiring more difficult for a period of time. But again, if you can't go back to work because whatever overlord that you're living under in your state won't let you, you're going to need that help. You know what I'd really like to see, though, and no one's talking about this, is I would like relief for people that have to declare bankruptcy. If you're a small business owner, if you're a restaurant, your retail, I don't care. It doesn't make any difference. If you have to shut down and you have to declare bankruptcy because the government forced you to, I would like that. You know, they always talk about permanent record. I want all of that information not on your permanent record. I don't want it to affect your credit. We need these people to want to get back in the game once things open up again and maybe want to reopen those businesses. And they're going to have a difficult time doing it with a bankruptcy on their record. I'd like to see that information go away so we can stimulate on the local level and bring back small business. As well, I'd like to see more money go to the SBA to help out entrepreneurs that want to take out loans to reopen many of these places that have closed.
Talking about moving ahead, getting back into the game, an NBC article cites this Glassdoor statistic that job openings fell by 2.5% on a month-to-month basis and are still down by more than 10% from pre-pandemic levels. Moving ahead, obviously, you mentioned before it's a holiday season. We're now going to be entering a new year, 2021. What does that indicate in terms of where the economy is heading?
There's a lot of uncertainty. We have, Joe Biden over the past couple of days has been talking about some of his tax plans. He wants to bring taxes back up to the levels it was during the Obama and the earlier parts of the Bush years, which is 39%. Also wanting to raise corporate taxes. There's also been some discussion in regards to raising payroll taxes. So businesses look at this, and again, they have to weigh. They have to say, what are my costs are going to be in regards to employing someone moving forward? That's a concern to them. And until that this is ironed out and the coast is clear, I think it's going to be more difficult. And I think we're going to have a difficult time, getting back to the numbers that we had pre-pandemic.
Yes, well, I was just looking to compare, where we are now in terms of unemployment to back in February, 3.5% unemployment in February compared to now we're at 6.7%. So it's going to be interesting to see how long it takes if we even are able to get back to that unemployment rate that we saw in February. Chris, thank you so much for joining me today. It's always great to have you, and I'm looking forward. Hopefully we'll have more positive news come our next round of jobs report. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Samantha.